and I'm not gonna let her catch you nohow. Oh, did she hurt you? Oh, she tried to, didn't she? Well, go tell Uncle Henry and Annie Hem. They'll take care of her. Come on! Annie Hem? Annie Hem?
Dorothy, please. I'm trying to count.
Oh, Annie Hem, just listen to what Miss Gold did to Toto. She said she was going to go get the sheriff.
Dorothy, please. We're busy.
Oh, but Annie Hem, she hit him.
Don't bother us now, honey.
You see? The old incubator's gone bad, and we're likely to lose a lot of our chicks.
Oh. Oh, those poor little things. Oh, but Annette, Miss Gulch hit Toto right over the back with a rake just because she says
Dorothy,
it gets her...
Please.
Oh, but he doesn't chase that old cat every day. It's just once or twice a week, and he can't catch it anyway. And now she said she's gonna go get the sheriff.
Dorothy, we're busy.
Uncle Henry, can't you do something?
I'm doing something right now, honey. Just stay out of her hair.
All right.
Who was the genius who decided to move the wagon before the wheel was fixed?
Oh, fixing ain't as easy as pushing. Well, that makes sense, don't it?
Sense or no sense, when I lift up on the wagon, you two shove her on.
See? Hickory, you know what Miss Gulch did to Toto?
I swear they made this new wheel smaller than the other one.
Well, she tried to kill him.
Bigger or smaller, just get her on there before my arms are pulled clean out their sockets. You know, I ain't a statue. I ain't made of iron.
Okay, okay.
Why won't anybody listen? Don't you all care about Toto?
Ow! Oh, you got my finger!
Hunk, what am I supposed to do about Miss Gulch?
Well, look at Dorothy. You're not using your brain about Miss Gulch. Ain't you got no brains?
Well, sure I have brains.
Well, why don't you use them? When you come home, don't go by Miss Gulch's place. No. Then Toto won't get in her garden, and you won't get in no trouble, see?
Quit just staying and then clear that junk out of the wagon. We got a parcel of lumber to haul from town before the weather turns.
Will do, Mr. Gale.
Zeke, what do you think I should do?
Well, for a start, kid, don't let that old Gulch heifer try and buffalo you. She ain't nothing to be afraid of. You gotta stand up to her, that's all. With a little courage, a little grit.
Well, I'm not afraid of her.
Well, that's what I wanted to hear. Walk with your head up, your chest out. And the next time she squawks, you just stroll right up to her and spit in her eye. That's what I'd do.
Would you really?
Sure I would. Through this life, you gotta walk tall, shoot straight, and then you got no reason to be scared of nothing and nobody.
Yeah! Oh! Oh, are you all right?
What are you trying to do, kill a guy?
Oh, how could you be so cruel?
Oh, it's just a rib, Dorothy.
Oh, well, can't you see how wide he is? You really scared him.
Who was scared?
You were scared. If you were a jackrabbit, you'd be in the next county by now.
Here, here, what's all this jabberwopping? I know three shiftless farmhands will be out of a job before they know it.
We was just having us some fun, Mrs. Gale.
Farm's no place for fun. You want fun? Go join a circus.
Might just do that. You know, be a strong man.
Don't start posing for it now. Here, can't work on an empty stomach? Ooh. Made some cookies.
Gosh, Mrs. Gale.
Just baked.
Thanks.
Swell.
You don't need to sit down to eat them. Go get that wagon hitched up. And Zeke, you go feed the hogs before they worry themselves into anemia.
Yes, ma'am.
Really, Aunt Em, I don't know what to do about Miss Gulch. She said she was going to get the sheriff.
Dorothy, stop imagining things. You always work yourself up for nothing.
Well.
Why don't you do us all a favor? Find yourself someplace where you won't be any trouble.
A place where there isn't any trouble. Well, do you suppose there is such a place, Toto? Oh, there must be.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic lane. troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Bluebirds fly.
By the barn.
I ain't skulked a day in my life, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
I need to speak with you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What's Dorothy done?
Well, I'm all but lame from the bite on my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
Afternoon, Miss Gulch. Made a fresh batch of cookies if you'd be inclined to sit a while.
I'm afraid I don't have an appetite, Miss Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken by the ferocious attack by your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
If you don't eat, you'll waste away. And I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here for a moment? Miss Gulch, I'm sure if Dorothy's done anything to upset you in any way, she'd be only more than happy to apologize.
Oh, we've gone beyond apologies, Miss Gale. I have laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Dorothy, Miss Gulch seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community.
Well, that's not true.
As an act of public service, young woman, I am taking that dog to the sheriff and having him destroyed.
Destroyed?
Now, Shirley, if she promised to give your place a wide berth.
You don't hand the dog over now. I'll bring a damage suit that'll take your whole farm. There's laws protecting folks against dogs that bite.
Oh, really, Aunt Em? Toto didn't mean to. He didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one that ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is. How would it be if he kept her? She kept him tied up. He's very gentle with gentle folk, that is.
That is for the sheriff to decide. Here is the order allowing me to take him, unless you want to go against the law.
Yeah.
What's it say, Henry?
Just what she says. You have to hand him over, Dorothy.
No. No.
Now you're seeing reason. Here's what I'm taking him in, so he can't attack me again.
No, no, I won't let you take him. You go away or I'll bite you myself.
Dorothy!
Oh, you wicked old witch. Uncle Henry, Aunt Em, please don't let him take Toto.
You stop her!
It's no use running, Dorothy.
I thought you were my friend, Hickory.
He is. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
Oh, Toto.
Hand him over, Dorothy.
That's more like it.
Oh, please, Uncle Henry.
Put him in the basket, Henry.
Oh, please, please don't.
More like it.
Almira Gulch, just because you own the entire county doesn't mean you can rule the rest of us. For 23 years, I've wanted to tell you exactly how I feel about you. Well, being a good Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can. If you don't want to hear it, you better pedal your carcass off my land.
I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Just remember, I have friends in high places.
Well, get on your broomstick and go visit them. You get that horse hitched to the wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Nearly ain't good enough. Get it done and get it done now. The sky's getting darker by the minute.
Come on, Dorothy, come inside.
No, I'm not going anywhere with you.
Dorothy, she had an order from the sheriff. What did you expect me to do? Wave a magic wand and make it all disappear?
Could have tried, at least.
Dorothy.
You just stood there like you was stuffed or something.
I'm sorry, I couldn't think of anything.
One mean old woman, and you were afraid of her.
It weren't my place to interfere.
You were worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away. And I just hate you.
Don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel all terrible inside, like my heart was all ripped out.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you again. Never, never, never. Toto was my only friend in the world, and now I've got no one to talk to and no one to play with, and I'm never going to see him again as long as I live. Toto? Oh, Toto! Oh, Toto! Oh, Toto, you got away from that horrible woman, you wonderful dog! Oh. She'll be coming back for you any minute. We've got to get away. We've got to run away. We'll need food for me and a bone for you. And then we'll go far, far away from here and we'll never, ever come back. Come on. Come on.
Here, doggy, doggy. Here, doggy, doggy. Where is that dratted animal? Here, doggy, doggy.
I thought I told you to get off my land.
I did, but the dogs got away.
They can't have enjoyed your company much.
Where the little girl is where I'll find the dog. Kindly bring her out here.
You don't give up, do you? Dorothy!
Henry,
Dorothy!
She's not in the house. And that fresh batch of cookies I made, they're gone. The picture from the mantle, it's gone too.
Sounds like you've got a runaway on your hands. If she's on the road, I'll find her, and then I'll take that dog back for good.
If you were so anxious to have it, you should have looked after it better.
But don't blame me. The catch on the basket was faulty. The last time I'll buy anything from a charity bazaar.
Tell me, you're going on a visit? No, that's not right. Let's see, you're running away.
Oh, how did you guess?
Professor Marvel never guesses, he knows. Now, why are you running away?
Well,
No, don't tell me. They don't understand you at home. They don't appreciate you. You want to see bigger lands, big mountains, big oceans, big cities,
Why, it's just like you could read what was inside of me.
It's my calling. It's my... See what it says on the side of my conveyance?
Yes.
Now, let's see. Where were we?
Oh, Professor Marvel, why can't we go with you and see all the crowned heads of Europe?
Do you know any?
Oh, well.
You mean the thing, yes. Well, I never go anywhere without consulting my crystal first.
Oh.
Here now, sit right down here. That's it, that's it. You make yourself comfortable while I conjure out of the air, out of the thin air, this very genuine magic, authentic crystal, first used by the priests of Isis and Osiris in the days of the pharaohs of Egypt, in which Cleopatra first saw the approach of Julius Caesar and Mark Antony and so on and so on. And here now, you hold out your hands to help me look into the future. Yes, yes, that's it. Now close your eyes for a moment, my child, in order to be better in tune with the infinite. Yes, yes, that's it. We can't do these things without looking and reaching into the infinite, huh? All right, now you can open them. Now we'll gaze into the crystal. What's this I see? A house with a picket fence.
Oh, that's our farm.
Let's see, there's a woman. She's wearing a polka dot dress. Her face is careworn.
Oh, that's Aunt Em.
Ah, yes. Her name is Emily.
Oh, that's right. What's she doing?
Well, I can't quite see what... Why, she's crying. Well, someone has hurt her. Someone has just about broken her heart.
Why would anyone do that?
Well, I don't know, but it's someone she loves very much. Someone she's been very kind to, and someone she's taken care of in sickness.
Well, I had the measles once, and she stayed right by me every minute. But that was when I was very small. Now I don't care about her, and she doesn't care about me.
Well, that's not what the crystal says.
Well, she was going to let them kill Toto.
Well, I don't see any of that in the crystal. All I see is a woman who does the best she can and who misses you something terrible.
Well, what's she doing now?
Well, what's this? She's putting her hand on her heart. What? Oh, she's dropping down onto the bed.
Oh, you don't suppose she could really be sick, do you?
Oh,
I've got to get to her right away.
But what's this? I thought you were going along with me.
No, I have to see her right now. Oh, come on, Toto. Goodbye, Professor Marvel. Thanks a lot.
Goodbye. Safe journey. I better get the horse under cover. There's a storm coming. A whopper. Oh, poor little kid. I hope she gets home all right.
Hurry up, cut them horses loose. Find Hickory. Hickory, doggone it, Hickory!
It's a twister! A twister, there she blows!
And it's heading straight for us!
The last time one of them struck, it tore the big barn clean out of the ground and left a cow sitting in the telegraph poles.
Ah, cut free the horses!
Good man!
Dorothy! Dorothy! Dorothy!
It's getting awful close, Mr. Gale.
Bring everybody into the storm cellar!
But Dorothy's still out here!
And Andy doesn't ask except to pray for all of us!
What's happening? Where am I? Why is it all moving?
Everything's flying. Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. We must be over the rainbow.
Are you a good witch or a bad witch?
Who, me? Oh, I'm not a witch at all. I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas.
Oh, is that the witch then?
Who, Toto? Toto's my dog.
Oh, well, I'm a little muddled. The Munchkins called me because a new witch has just dropped a house on the Wicked Witch of the East. And there's the house, and here you are, and those legs are all that's left of the Wicked Witch of the East. So what the Munchkins want to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
Oh, but I've already told you, I'm not a witch at all. Witches are old and ugly. What was that?
The Munchkins. They're laughing because I'm a witch. I'm Glinda, the Witch of the North.
Oh, you are? Well, I beg your pardon. I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly. The Munchkins are happy because you have freed them from the Wicked Witch of the East.
But if you please, what are Munchkins?
The little people who live in this land, and blue is their favorite color. This is Munchkin Land, and you are their national heroine, my dear. It's all right. You may all come out and thank her.
Thank you.
wish to welcome you to Munchkin Lair.
And she's worse than the other one was.
Where's my sister?
Yonder she lies.
Where?
There.
All right, who's the smart aleck that turned her into a house? Was it you, Glinda?
Not the house. Under the house.
Under the house.
It's my fault. I'm so sorry. My house dropped on her.
You dropped your house on my sister? How can anyone be so unbelievably clumsy?
Look closer. You recognized her then?
Of course I recognize her. Who else would wear ruby slippers with those socks? Oh, the ruby slippers. Little girl, you have done me a service. I shall don the ruby slippers, and my powers will be greater than ever! Oh, they've gone! The ruby slippers! They're gone! What have you done with them?
See for yourself. Step forward, Dorothy.
Give them back to me, or I'll...
It's too late. There they are, and there they'll stay.
Give them back to me. I'm the only one that knows how to use them. They're of no use to you. Give them back to me. Give them back.
Keep tight inside them. They must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
You better stay out of this, Glinda, or I'll fix you as well.
No fiddle-faddle. You have no power while I'm here. Be gone before someone drops a house on you, too.
Very well. I'll bide my time. But as for you, my fine lady, it's true. I can't attend to you here and now as I would like. But after a suitable period of mourning, I'll have those slippers and my revenge as well. So best just try to stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you eventually, my pretty. And your little dog, too.
All right, you can all come out now. She's gone. It's all right. You can come out. The smell of sulfur in the air. You've made a very powerful enemy of the Wicked Witch, my dear. The sooner you get out of Oz altogether, the safer you'll sleep.
Oh, I'd give anything to get out of Oz altogether. My Auntie Em is missing me, and she may even be ill. But which is the way back to Kansas? I can't go the way I came.
No, that's true. The only person who might know would be the great and wonderful Wizard of Oz himself.
The Wizard of Oz? Is he good or is he wicked?
Oh, very good, but very mysterious. He He lives in the Emerald City, and that's a long way from here. Did you bring your broomstick with you?
No, I'm afraid I didn't.
Then you'll just have to walk. The Munchkins will see you safely to the border of Munchkin Land. And remember, never let those ruby slippers off your feet, or you'll be at the mercy of the Wicked Witch of the West.
But how do I start for the Emerald City?
It's always best to start at the beginning, and all you do is follow the yellow brick road.
But what happens if
Just follow the yellow brick road. Goodbye.
My, you people come and go so quickly here. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow, 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 follow the yellow brick road.
Where do we go?
Pardon me. That way is a very nice way.
Who said that? Oh, don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows can't talk.
It's pleasant down that way, too.
Well, that's funny. Wasn't he just pointing the other way?
Of course, people do go both ways.
Why? You did say something, didn't you? Are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
Well, I don't have a brain. Only straw. So I don't have a mind to make up.
How can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
I don't know. But some people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
Yes, I guess you're right. Can't you get down?
Down? No, you see, I've got a pole stuck up my back.
Oh, well, could I help you?
Well, of course, I'm not very bright about doing things. But I imagine if you'll just bend the nail down and back, I'll just slip off.
Oh, well, I'll certainly try. It's an awful stiff nail.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Oh!
Oh. Oops, there goes some more of me again.
Oh, does that hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in again.
Well, let me help you.
My, it's good to be free. Whoa!
Oh! Huh?
Oh, did I scare you?
Oh, no, I just thought you hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you?
No, of course not.
Oh, I didn't think so. You see, I can't even scare a crow.
Howdy, neighbor!
They come from miles around to eat in my field.
Howdy, scarecrow!
And laugh in my face. Said a scarecrow sitting on a pole to a blackbird sitting on a fence. Well, the Lord gave me a soul, but forgot to give me common sense.
Well, well, well.
to reason out the reason of the witchness and the whiness and the whence. If I had an ounce of common sense, I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. Oh, my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts you'd be thinking, you could be another Lincoln.
If I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore.
You could think of things you never thunk before.
And then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing, my head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry, life would be a ding-a-dairy if I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore.
I could think of things I never thought before.
And then I'd sit and think some more. Gosh, it would be awful pleasing to reason out the reason for things I can't explain. Then perhaps I'd deserve ya and be even worthy of ya if I only had a brain. Whoa!
Oh.
If I only had a brain.
Kansas could do that, the crows would be scared to pieces.
Really? Oh, well, where is Kansas?
Well, that's where I live, and I want to get back there so badly I'm going all the way to the Emerald City to get the Wizard of Oz to help me.
You're going to see the Wizard?
Uh-huh.
Well, do you think if I came along, the Wizard would give me some brains?
Well, I can't say. But even if he didn't, you'd be no worse off than you are now.
Well, yes, that's true.
But maybe you'd better not. I've got a witch mad at me, and I wouldn't want you to get into trouble.
A witch, huh? I'm not afraid of a witch. I'm not afraid of anything. Well, except a lighted match.
No, I don't blame you for that.
No, but I'd face a whole box full of them at a chance for some brains. Listen, I won't be any trouble because I don't eat. And I won't try to manage things because I can't think. Won't you please take me with you?
Oh, of course I will.
Hooray! Now I'm going to get me some brains. Let's go. No!
Oh, well, you're not starting out very well.
I'll try. Really, I will.
To Oz?
To Oz!
We're off to see the Wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard, a wizard, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, oh, ever a wiz there was, their Wizard of Oz is one because of the wonderful things he does.
I'm not alive?
Oh, Scarecrow, you are the liveliest friend I've ever had.
Why, thank you. Just for that, you can eat as much of my hay as you'd like. Then you won't be hungry anymore.
Oh, I couldn't do that.
Oh, you don't have to worry about me. So long as I keep my legs well stuffed, I can get to Emerald City no matter what shape I'm in up top.
Oh, Scarecrow, that's a very kind offer, but I don't eat hay.
Oh, well, perhaps it's just as well. A little mother field mouse has a nest in here, and she'd rather not be disturbed.
Oh, look, Scarecrow, apples!
Apples? What's apples?
Well, they're hanging from the trees.
Oh, you mean those little red birds hanging by one leg.
Well, they're not birds. They're something you eat, and they're delicious.
Oh,
but we've been walking a long ways, and I was hungry, and I just... Did you say something?
Oh, she was hungry.
How'd you like to have someone come along and pick something off you?
Oh, I'm sorry. I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas.
Oh, come along, Dorothy. You don't want any of those apples. Yuck.
Are you saying that my apples aren't what they are
to me? Well, no. I'm just saying that she doesn't like little green worms.
Worms?
That's what it sounded like to me.
I'll show you how to get apples. Well, sure you got worms. Worms, caterpillars, and probably a whole bunch of wood lice, too.
How dare you? Let's give it to them, girls.
Oh!
Oh!
Look out, Dorothy!
Face slander!
Do you mind if I take this?
How do you like them apples?
We like them just fine.
They made a sap out of all of us.
You're not going to eat that.
Either. I think maybe it's time we bowed out.
Why, it's a man.
What?
A man made out of tin. Oh, look.
Oil can.
Did you say something?
Oil can.
He said oil can.
Oh, oil can what?
Oil can. Oh! Well, where do you want to be oiled first?
My mouth. My mouth.
Oh, he said his mouth.
Oh.
The other side.
Yes, right there.
Oh, my goodness. I can talk again. Oh, oil my arms and my elbows. Oh.
Oh, does that hurt you?
Oh, no. It feels wonderful. I've held up that axe for ages.
Oh, goodness. Well, how did you ever get like this?
Well, when I was once flesh and blood like you, I fell in love with a Munchkin maiden whose mother hated me. And so, to stop me from marrying her daughter, she hired the Wicked Witch of the West to cast an evil spell on my axe. And so, when I went to chop down a tree, I chopped off my leg instead.
You chopped your leg off?
Oh, how terrible.
But, by good fortune, I knew of a wonderful tinsmith who made me a new leg almost as good as the old one.
Oh.
So back to work I went, and guess what happened?
Something terrible, I bet.
I swung my axe, and dang me if it didn't take off the other leg.
Oh, you should have got a new axe.
I guess you're right, but I got me a new leg instead, and back I went to work.
You sure were persistent.
And this time, I chopped off both my arms.
Well, hold on, I can see how you could have managed to chop off one arm, but how'd you get the other?
I told you, the axe was enchanted.
Oh, of course. You see, Dorothy, if I had a brain, I could have worked that out for myself.
Even though I sometimes wish I didn't get a new set of arms because, well, the last time I swung the axe was the worst of all.
Oh, I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
I split myself, right? Down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing.
I went back to the tinsmith and got a new head and body. But on the way home, there was a terrible rainstorm, and I rusted solid.
Oh, it just wasn't your day, was it?
I've been here ever since.
Well, you're perfect now.
Oh, my neck. My neck. Oh, perfect. Well, if you think I'm so perfect, bang on my chest. Go ahead, bang on it.
Beautiful. What an echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
No heart?
No heart.
Oh.
All hollow. And, well, without a heart, well, I'll never be able to love my Munchkin maiden.
Oh, Tin Man, please don't cry. You rust so dreadfully.
I used to carve her name on every tree.
And a tin man rattling his jibs to a straw man sat and weary eyed.
Old smith gave me tin ribs, but forgot to put a heart inside.
Then he banged his own chest.
When a man's an empty kettle. He should be on his mettle, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kinda human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy who shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me, a balcony, above a voice sings low.
Where from though, Romeo?
I hear a beat.
Oh, how sweet!
Just to register emotion, jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I'd be young, I'd be chipper, I would lock it with a zipper if I only had a heart. I'm a bit rusty yet.
Well, could you visit the tinsmith and ask him to make you a new heart?
Oh, no. He ran out of business a long time ago.
Oh, ran out of tin.
Well, perhaps you could come with us to the Emerald City to ask the Wizard of Oz for a heart.
Suppose he wouldn't give me one when we got there.
Oh, he will. He must. We've come such a long way already. Oh! Oh!
You call that long? Why, you've only just begun.
You're the one who put a spell on my axe.
Chopped you down to size, didn't it? And now you're helping the little lady along, are you, my fine gentleman? Well, you better stay away from her. Or Scarecrow, I'll stuff a mattress with you. Tin Man, I'll use you for a beehive.
Oh, I'm not afraid of you.
Well, that just proves you don't have a brain. Let me educate you. Would you like to play ball?
I'm not a big fan of... Oh! I'm on fire! Fire! Help!
Just remember, Scarecrow, helping that girl get to the Emerald City could be your last burning ambition.
I'm still not afraid of her. Now I'll make sure you see the wizard, whether I get a brain or not. Stuff a mattress with me, ha!
I'll see that you get to the wizard, whether I get a heart or not. Make a beehive out of me, bah!
Oh, you two are the best friends anybody ever had. And it's funny, I feel as if I've known you all along. But I couldn't have, could I?
I don't see how. You weren't there when I was stuffed and sewn together, were you?
And I was over there, rusting for the longest time.
still wish I could remember. But it doesn't really matter. We know each other now, don't we?
That's right.
We do.
To Oz?
To Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard, a wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, oh, ever a wiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
I wouldn't be caught dead in that forest.
If I grew there, I'd be petrified.
I don't like this forest. It's dark and creepy.
Well, of course, I'm not very bright, but I think it's going to get darker before it gets lighter.
Oh, do you suppose we'll meet any wild animals?
We might.
Oh, wild animals that eat straw.
Oh, well, some, but mostly lions and tigers. And bears.
Lions.
And tigers.
And bears.
Ooh.
Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my.
Put them up. Which one of you fights? I'll fight you both together if you want. I'll fight you with one paw tied behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Oh, pulling an axe on me, huh? Sneaking up on me, why?
Go away. Leave us alone.
Oh, scared, huh? Afraid, huh? How long can you stay fresh in that can? Come on, man up and fight, you shivering junkyard. Put your hands up, you lopsided bag of hay.
Oh, well, that's getting personal, lion.
Yeah, you get up and teach him a lesson.
What's wrong with you teaching him?
Well, I'll get you anyway, Pee-wee.
Shame on you!
What did you do that for? I didn't bite him.
No, but you tried to. It's bad enough picking on a straw man, but then when you go around picking on poor little dogs...
Well, you didn't have to go and hit me, did you? Is my nose bleeding?
No, of course not. Naturally, when you go around picking on things weaker than you are... My goodness, what a fuss you're making. Well, you're nothing but a great big coward.
Oh, you're right. I am a coward. I haven't got any courage at all. I even scare myself. Look at the circles under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Why don't you try counting sheep?
That wouldn't do any good. I'm afraid of them.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Why don't you come along with us? We're on our way to see the wizard to get him a heart.
And him a brain.
I'm sure he could give you some courage.
Well, wouldn't you feel degraded to be seen in the company of a cowardly lion? I would.
Oh, no, of course not.
Oh, gee, that's awfully nice of you. My life has been simply unbearable. Even my family's disowned me. When I was just a little cub, my father took me to the top of a high mountain, waved his paw around, and said, "One day, son, all this will be yours." Oh, I was terrified.
Well, why's that?
I'm scared of heights.
Oh. Well, the wizard will fix everything.
At least you'll be safe if I come with you.
How's that?
No self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me. Said a lion, poor neurotic lion, to a miss who'd listen to him rave. Oh, the Lord made me a lion, but the Lord forgot to make me brave. Then his tail began to curl and wave. Life is... sad, believe me, Missy, when you're born to be a sissy without the feminine.
change my habits. Never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the noise. I'm afraid there's no denying I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't deserve. But I could show my prowess, be a lion, not a Maoist, if I only had the knife.
Oh, you'd be in your stride, a king down to your core.
You could roar the way you've never roared before.
And then I'd roar, 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 and roar some more. I could show the dinosaurus who's king around the forest, a king they better sight. Why, with my regal visa, I could be another Caesar if I only had the knife. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard, sir,
then I'm sure to get a brain, a heart,
a home,
the knife.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard, a wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, oh, ever a wiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
Depressing is boundless optimism. Happily, it's totally misplaced. Now, shall I squash them like the interfering little bugs that they are? Or shall I be witty and creative? The bug alternative is attractive, but messy. So, witty and creative wins the day. Let's see, something with poison in it, I think. With poison, attractive to the eye, and soothing to the smell. Poppies! 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 This lethal lullaby will put them to sleep forever, and the ruby slippers will be mine!
Tired, Dorothy, we could take a shortcut.
The road curves around this poppy field, or we could cut through and then pick up on the other side.
Oh. Oh. Oh, I've never seen such beautiful poppies.
I think poppies are my favorite flower.
The smell, it's so wonderful, and all the singing.
I can hear it too. It sounds just like the heavenly semaphore.
Now we've got to go on.
Come to think of it, 40 weeks wouldn't be a bad idea.
Oh, don't you start too.
Oh, it's the poppies. It's the poppies that's doing it all. No.
Oh, don't cry. You'll rust yourself again. This is a spell, this is.
It's the Wicked Witch. Oh, what do we do? Oh, help.
Don't cry. Help. There's no point. No one's going to hear us.
My own can save the day.
It's snowing.
Oh,
I just realized something.
What?
I'm sitting on it. Boy, those poppies are powerful stuff. I didn't feel a thing.
Has done its work. Journey's End is now in sight.
Ready?
Ready. You're out of the woods, you're out of the dark, you're out of the night. Step into the sun, step into the light. Keep straight ahead.
Just like I knew it would be. He really must be a powerful wizard to live in a city like that.
Well, come on then.
Best on to Oz.
To Oz.
To Oz.
We're off to see the
We're
wizard.
We're off to see the wizard.
We're off to see the
We're
wizard.
To see the, wizard.
The wonderful wizard of Oz.
Thank you.
Thank you. winding rain. You're some kind of butterfly. Baby, you give me fear that you whip up my appetite. Don't leave me here high and dry.
is down, what's left is right. Chasing stars and holding view. I can't see the end, but we'll see it through.
Myself wondering what had happened to the last 10. I ran away with my life fast forward, never turned back. signs. Is this really happening? I can't believe it's true. I'm just as surprised as you. Is this really happening? I can't be too sure, but one day I'll be yours again. The other 11 get something from nothing. I sit here looking for an answer. Maybe the biggest question was in the last chapter. You gave me the soul I have today. Without you I never could have moved away. But now I seek what you teach. I do believe I always should have stayed. Yeah. Is this really happening? I can't believe it's true. I'm just as surprised as you. This really happened here. I can't be too sure, but one day I'll be yours again. One day I'll be yours. One day I'll be yours. One day I'll be yours. Life lessons come one in a dozen. The other 11 get something from nothing. Life lessons come one in a dozen. The other 11 get something from nothing. Life lessons come one in a dozen. The other 11 get something from nothing. Life changes just open the door. One thing's certain, I'll always be yours.
Just as surprised as you. heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven, and the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to climb a mountain and to reach the highest peak, but it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to go out fishing in a river or a creek, but I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Dance with me, I want my arm about you. The charm about you will carry me through to heaven. I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
So high.
Oh, I'm getting giddy just looking at them.
Wow. Go ahead, Scarecrow. Ring the bell. Let them know we're here.
Okay. Here goes.
Oh! Ring that bell!
Don't do that!
He did.
We did.
Can't you read?
Oh, read what?
The notice!
What notice?
Oh, it's on the door. As plain as the nose on my face. It's... It's just a minute.
Bell out of order.
order, please knock.
Well, that's more like it. Now, state your business.
We want to see the wizard.
Call the wizard? But nobody can see the Great Oz. Nobody's ever seen the Great Oz. Even I've never seen him.
Well, then how do you know there is one?
Because if there wasn't a wizard, then why would you be here?
Oh, please, sir, the Good Witch of the North sent us.
Prove it.
She's wearing the ruby slippers she gave her.
Oh, so she is. Well, bust my buttons. Why didn't you say that in the first place? That's a horse of a different color.
Who's he calling a horse? If he wasn't on the other side of that door.
He's coming out.
He'd be on this side.
Welcome to the Emerald City.
Oh, thank you.
Have you come far?
Oh, just the longest wait.
Well, believe me, every step is worth it. Have you any idea just how wonderful this place really is?
Well, I've tried to imagine it, but I haven't got a brain.
They said I'd fall in love with it if I had a heart.
It's the one place I don't need courage, because there's nothing there to scare me. Is there?
There's a garden spot, I'm told, where it's never too hot and it's never too cold.
Where you're never too young and you're never too old.
And you're never too thin or tall.
And you're never, never, never too anything at all.
It's all true. Oh, we're not too mad and we're not too sane. And we don't compare and we don't complain. All we do is just sit tight. 'Cause it's all so, so, so downright right. Come with me! Crickets crick all day in the merry old land of Oz. We get up at 12 and start to work at 1. Taking off for lunch and then at 2 we're done.
Jolly good fun!
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away in the merry old land of Oz.
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away in the merry old land of Oz.
Will you take us to him?
Is he scary?
The wizard. Yes, of course. But first, why don't I take you to a little place you can tidy up a bit? Over there!
Oh, thank you.
Traffic on 67.
Oh, they're awfully busy.
Thank you.
hearts and then at two or dime.
Don't get fun!
Ha ha ha! Ho ho ho! And a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away in the merry old land of Oz. That's how we laugh the day away with a ha ha ha! Ha ha ha! Ha ha ha! Ha ha ha! Ha ha ha!
What's she doing with all that smoke? She's riding with it.
What's it say? What's it say?
Surrender, Dorothy.
Dorothy? Who's Dorothy?
The wizard will explain it.
To the wizard!
To the wizard!
Here. Everything is all right. Stop that now. It's all right. Everything is all right. The great power of Oz is better as well in him. I hope. And so you can all just go home, and there's nothing more to worry about. Get out of here now. Go. Get. Go home. Come on. Get out of here. Go. Get. Didn't you hear me? I said go home.
Oh, please, sir. That's just what I'm trying to do. That's why we have to see the wizard right away, all four of us.
Orders are nobody can see the Great Oz. Not nobody, not no how.
Oh, but...
You said you'd take us to him.
Not nobody, not no how.
Please.
But Dorothy, you just gotta make him see.
Dorothy? Did you just say Dorothy? The witch is Dorothy.
In person.
Well, that makes a difference. Wait right here. I'll announce you at once.
Did you hear that? He'll announce us at once. Oh. I've as good as got my brain.
I can faintly feel a palpitation.
I'll be home in time for supper.
In another hour, I'll be king of the forest. Long live the king! If I were king of the forest, not queen, not duke, not prince. My regal robes of the forest would be satin, not cotton, not chintz. I'd command each thing, be it fish or fowl, with a whoop and a whoop and a royal. As I'd click my heel, all the trees would kneel, and the mountains bow, and the bulls would bow, and the sparrows would take wing. Would show respect to me, the chipmunks genuflect to me, though my tail would lash, I would show compassion to every underling. Bye, we're king, just king.
Monarch of all you survey.
not know how?
Not even a rhinoceros?
Imposterous.
What if it were a hippopotamus?
Why, I'd thrash him from top to bottom.
Well, suppose you met an elephant?
I'd wrap him up in cellophane.
What if it were a brontosaurus?
I'd show him who is king of the forest.
How?
Courage. What makes a king out of a slave? Courage. What makes the flag on the mast wave? Courage. What makes the elephant charge his tusk in the misty mist or the dusky dusk? What makes the muskrat guard his musk? Courage. What makes the Sphinx the seventh wonder? Courage. What makes the dawn come up like thunder? Courage. What makes the Hottentot so hot? What puts the ape in apricot? And what do they got?
Courage!
You could say that again.
Courage is a thing of things.
With courage I'd be king of kings.
And the whole year round I'd be hailed and crowned by every living thing.
He is deaf to all appeals.
You said you'd take us to him.
The wizard has spoken! Looks like we came a long way for nothing.
I was so happy. I thought I was on my way home. Now, I'll never get home.
Don't cry, Dorothy. We'll get you to the wizard. Somehow.
We certainly will.
Annie M was so good to me, and I never appreciated her. Running away and hurting her feelings, and now she may even be dying. And it's all my fault. And I'll never forgive myself. Never, never, never.
Oh, please don't cry anymore, Dorothy. I'll get you to the wizard somehow.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, that's all right. You know, I knew an Auntie M once myself. Right this way. Come with me.
Whoa, wait a minute, fellas. I don't really want to see the wizard this much. I think I better wait outside.
Oh, but what's the matter? The wizard will give you some courage.
I'd be too scared to ask him for it.
Oh, come on, Lion. We can be scared together.
Oh. To what happened? Oh,
somebody pulled my tail.
Oh, you did it yourself.
I'm such a butterfly.
Right this way. Come with me. The Great Oz awaits you.
Oh, tell me when it's over.
Right this way. Follow me.
Look at that. Look at that. I want to go home.
I am Oz, the great and powerful. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? And who are you?
Oh, if you please, sir, I am Dorothy the Small and Meek.
Silence!
Oh, Jiminy Crickets!
The great and powerful Oz knows why you have come. Step forward, Tin Man! You dare to come to me for a heart, do you? You clinking, clanking, clattering collection of pillaginous junk!
Yes, sir. Your honor. Well, you see, we were just walking down the yellow brick road and...
Quiet! And you Scarecrow. You have the effrontery to ask me for a brain. You billowing bale of bovine fodder.
Yes, Your Honor. I mean, Your Excellency. Your wizardry.
Enough! And you, lion. Well.
Oh, you ought to be ashamed of yourself, frightening him like that when he came to ask you for help.
Silence, whippersnapper. The beneficent Oz has every intention of granting your request.
What's that? What'd he say?
Are you all right?
Just a little deaf. What'd he say?
Well, he's gonna help us after all.
He is.
But first, you must prove yourselves worthy by performing a very small task.
A small task? Is that all?
You name it, and it's half done.
Bring me the broomstick of the Witch of the West.
But if we do that, well, we'll have to kill her to get it.
Bring me her broomstick, and I'll grant your requests. Now go!
But what if she kills this boy?
I said go!
No, hurry.
You've given up this crazy scheme. I never should have let you see the wizard.
Oh, but I'm so glad you did. How else would I get back to Kansas?
You don't have to worry about us.
We're not going after the witch empty-handed.
You can say that again.
Which way to her castle?
No one knows for sure.
You mean no one's ever gone there?
Oh, plenty of folk have gone there, but nobody's ever come back.
Oh, boy.
There's no yellow brick road to follow now.
Oh, there's no road at all in the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? What Winkies?
But once they were people very like us, but then the Wicked Witch made them her slaves.
I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you.
Oh, so do I.
Keep going west to where the sun sets.
Is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
You won't have to find her, Dorothy. When she knows you're in the land of the Winkies, she'll find you. Good luck!
Well, sometimes it's a good thing not to have a brain. Well, I haven't the wit to be scared.
And I haven't the heart to fail.
And I haven't just said goodbye to the wizard.
Well, don't go leaving Dorothy now.
Oh.
I could stay here. That's one way of doing it.
Oh, shame on you. You're even more of a coward than I thought.
Well, you're made of straw. It's easy for you to speak. And you're made of tin. But I am only weak flesh.
Very weak.
Virgin on flabby.
Oh, it's all right, Lion. You could stay here if you like.
I'd like. Oh, how I'd like. But if you really need me, I'll tag along, I guess.
That's more like it.
Yeah, you can guard us against the flying monkeys.
Ready to go, Dorothy?
Certainly.
Into my territory. But how do I bring her before me? Winkies! Winkies! Come forth!
We
loathsome dirge.
Well, ever since you put your foot through a drum, how else are we supposed to keep in step?
What does it mean, anyway?
You mean yo wee yo, yo ho, yo wee yo, yo ho, yo wee yo, yo ho.
The next time I enslave a whole nation, I must check their intelligence first. Nico! Nico! Where is my commander of my aerobatic apes? There you are, my simian minion. I have a very important task for you. My enemies are about to enter the haunted forest. I want you to rouse your men and snatch up the sickening little girl and her equally nauseating little dog. Exhausted? What do you mean you're exhausted? Oh, all right. I'll conjure up a spell to take the fight out of her. Which one of my creepy crawly creations shall I send to plague her? The Flipperty Gibbet? Oh. The Fly By Night? Oh, I have it! The Jitterbug! Oh, well may you jibber! It is the most infectious bug in my book of spells. Once bitten, they can't stop dancing until they drop. And then you'll be there to scoop up the little brat and the little brute and to bring them before me. Now go! Do my bidding! Fly! 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 Soon those dainty, darling little slippers will be on my lovely little feet. I wonder if any of the Winkies do shoe repairing.
Well, passed a notice a while back.
You mean the one that said, "Welcome to the haunted forest"?
No, the one that said, "If you've come this far, you're lost."
Well, there's another notice.
Oh, let's hope this one's a little more reassuring.
I'd turn back if I were you.
Bye. Oh, no!
I believe there's spooks around here.
Spooks? That's ridiculous.
Don't you believe in spooks?
No. Well, why only fools believe in spooks?
What?
So do I. Did you just hear what I just heard?
That sound don't come from an ordinary bird.
It may be just a cricket or a critter in the trees.
It's giving me the jitters and the joints around the knees.
I think I see a shadow and it's fuzzy and it's furry.
I haven't got a brain, but I think I better worry.
I don't have a heart, but I feel a palpitation.
It's not a good forest. I don't like the situation.
Well, are you gonna sit around and let him fill us full of horror?
I'd like to roar him down, but I think I lost my roarer.
It's a hoosis!
It's a hoosis!
It's a watches!
It's a watches!
What's that?
Who's there?
Who's there? Beware!
Who's that hiding in the treetops? It's that rascal, the jitterbug. Should you catch him buzzing round you, keep away from the jitterbug. Oh, the bees in the breeze and the bats in the trees have a terrible, horrible buzz. But the bees and the breeze and the bats and the trees don't do what the jitterbug does. So be careful of that rascal. Keep away from the jitterbug. The jitterbug. Oh, the bees and the breeze and the bats and the trees have a terrible, horrible buzz. But the bees and the breeze and the bats and the trees don't do what the jitterbug does. So be careful of that rascal. Keep away. The jitterbug.
Oh. 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 Scarecrow!
chitterbug. 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 Look out for that bug!
Oh no, here we go again!
Oh, I'm suffering from metal fatigue!
Oh, please leave us alone!
What?
Oh, what?
Oh!
They tore my arm off and threw it over there.
Oh, Scarecrow, that's you all over.
Time you pulled yourself together.
Oh, I would, but I can't reach my legs. Oh, I got any extra stuffing? Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, okay. Oh. All right. All right. Now to find Dorothy.
That's right. And the lion will lead us.
Yeah. Me?
Yeah.
I'm gonna lead us against the forces of evil.
Well, that's right.
All right. I'll do it for Dorothy. Wicked witch or no wicked witch, gods or no gods, I'll tear him apart. I may not come out alive, but I'll go down fighting. There's only one thing I want you fellas to do.
What's that?
Drug me out of it.
Tonight we feast on devil dog.
Oh no!
Oh, it's all right, my dear. Just my little joke. He'll be equally revolting with an apple in his mouth. Here, take him.
Where are you taking him? Why can't he stay here with me?
Well, the raging, roaring river is some way off. Is he a water breed?
I don't think so.
Well, he soon will be, if you don't hand over those slippers.
But the Good Witch of the North told me not to.
Very well. Take the basket and throw it into the deepest point of the river and drown him.
Oh, no, no, you can have your slippers yourself. I don't want them. Just give me back my dog.
Oh, there's a good little girl. I knew you would see reason.
Toto? Oh, run, Toto, run as far as you can!
Catch him!
Run,
catch
Toto! Him! Oh, he got away! He got away from you!
Which is more than you will ever do. Fool that I am, I should have remembered those slippers will never come off as long as you're alive. Do you see this? Longer you have to be alive. And it's not very long, my pretty. Just long enough for me to devise a very unpleasant yet wildly entertaining death for you. Oh, there is one route of escape. It's a long way down, and the rocks are sharp. Should you choose this way, be a darling and leave the ruby slippers on the window sill. It'll save us from having to pry them off your corpse.
Oh, how could anyone be so nasty and mean and cruel?
Lots and lots of practice.
Oh, Auntie Em. Auntie Em, I'm so frightened, Auntie Em. witch's castle.
Dorothy, I've been looking for you everywhere. Where are you? Dorothy!
Oh, Auntie Em, I'm in Oz, and I'm trying to get back to
Dorothy.
You.
Dorothy!
Oh, come back, Auntie Em, come back!
Auntie Em, I'll give you Auntie Em, my pretty.
What's that? What's that?
It's the castle of the Wicked Witch.
Dorothy's in that awful place.
Oh, I hate to think of her in there.
Oh, don't cry, Tin Man. We haven't got the oil can, and you've been squeaking enough as it is.
But I've heard the place has 1,000 rooms. How are we gonna know which one Dorothy's in? Oh.
Oh, it's Toto!
Here, Toto!
Oh, Toto will lead us to Dorothy! Oh,
you think it'd be polite dropping in like this?
Look out!
Oh. Who's them? Who's them?
Shh! Listen, I think I've got how to get us inside.
Fine, he's got a plan.
It might not work.
It might not work.
But it's got a chance.
It's got a chance.
Only thing is, it's very, very dangerous. What do you say?
I say, anyone else got a plan?
Let's hear Scarecrow's.
First thing is we need to get a hold of three Winky uniforms.
Three Winky uniforms?
Where are we gonna find three Winky uniforms?
I don't know, but the plan depends on it.
Three Winky uniforms.
Fellas, we don't have to look far.
Oh.
They're right there!
Oh.
Troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me. Oh, the hourglass is almost out. Good Witch of the North, can't you help me now? Please, can anybody help me?
Dorothy! Dorothy, are you in there?
It's us. Are you all right?
Yes. Yes, I'm fine, but the witch has locked me in. Please hurry.
Well, here, stand back while I break it open.
Hurry, please hurry. The hourglass is almost empty.
Dorothy.
Oh, Toto. Toto.
Come on. There's no time to lose.
We can't take her back the way we came.
Well, what about the window?
Oh, the cliff is awfully sheer.
Don't worry. You hang on to my tail, and I'll hang on with my claws.
Oh, you're all so wonderful, all of you.
I just hope my courage holds out.
Well, we hope your tail holds out.
To the window! I think we've outstayed our welcome.
Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of spears. I see the sands of time have run out for all of you. The last to go will see the first three before her. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Lion? Girl? Tin Man? No!
My broom chooses Scarecrow.
No. How?
What? How? Don't you want to be my old flame? And I'll get to you eventually, Miss Mouth. So you want to see your friend go up in smoke?
No, help!
Too late, Scarecrow. You're all burned up.
No! I won't let you.
What? No! Oh, you cursed brat! What have you done? I'm melting! Melting! What a world! What a world! Who would have thought a good little girl like you could destroy my beautiful wickedness?
I'm melting!
She's dead. You've killed her.
Oh, I didn't mean to kill her. Really, I didn't. It's just that she was going to set him on fire.
All hail Dorothy. The Wicked Witch is dead.
All hail Dorothy.
You are now our new queen.
Oh, that's very kind, but I have to get home to Kansas. But one thing, the witch's broom, may we have it?
Please. Take it with you.
Oh, thank you so much.
The Wicked Witch is dead. Ding dong, witch is dead. Witch old witch, the Wicked Witch. Ding dong, the Wicked Witch is dead. Gone where the goblins go below, 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 yo ho. Let's open up and sing and ring the bells out. Ding dong, the merrier.
Sing it high,
sing it low.
Forward if you dare!
Huh?
Can I believe my eyes? Why have you come back?
Oh, please, sir, we've done what you asked of us. We brought you the broomstick of the Witch of the West. We melted her.
Oh, you liquidated her, eh? Very resourceful.
So, if you please, sir, we'd like you to keep your promise.
Not so fast, not so fast. I'll have to give the matter a little thought. Go away and come back tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh, but I need to go home now.
You've had plenty of time already.
Do not arouse the wrath of the great and powerful Oz. I said come back tomorrow.
If you are really great and powerful, you keep your promises.
Do you presume to criticize the great Oz? Ungrateful creatures, think yourself lucky that I am giving you an audience tomorrow instead of 20 years from now.
Toto?
The great Oz has spoken. Now go!
Toto, what is it?
I said go! I pay no attention to that man behind the curtain. The great and powerful Oz has spoken.
Who are you?
Well, I am the great and powerful Wizard of Oz.
I don't believe you.
Well, I'm afraid it's true. There is no other wizard except me.
You humbug!
Yeah!
Well, that's exactly so. Well, I'm a humbug.
What about
You're
the
You're a very bad man.
No, my dear, I'm a very good man. I'm just a very bad wizard.
What about the heart you promised Tin Man?
And Scarecrow's brain.
Well, anybody can have a brain. A brain is a very modest commodity. Back where I come from, we have universities where men go to think great thoughts. And when they come out, they think deep thoughts. And they have no more brains than you have, but they have one thing you haven't got. A diploma. Therefore, by the virtue invested in me, I, Universitalis Comitiatum, e pluribus unum, I take pleasure at this time in presenting you with this concessionary degree, a Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
Oh, yeah, yes, well, that's a doctor of thinkology.
Oh. The sum of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle is equal to the remaining side. Joy! Rapture! How can I ever thank you?
Well, you can't. And as for you, my fine friend, you are under the unfortunate delusion that just because you run from danger, you have no courage. You are confusing wisdom with courage. Back where I come from, we have men who are called heroes. And once a year, they take their fortitude out of the mothballs and parade it down the main street of the city. And they have no more courage than you have, but they have one thing you haven't got. A medal. Therefore, for meritorious conduct, extraordinary valor, and conspicuous bravery against wicked wishes, I award you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage.
Thanks, folks. I'm speechless.
And as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be practical until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing but good deeds all day. They are called good deed doers. And their hearts are no bigger than yours. But they've got one thing you haven't got, a testimonial. Therefore, in consideration of your kindness, I take pleasure at this time in presenting you with a small token of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others.
Oh, Joy, listen, it ticks. Oh, it ticks.
Read what my medal says.
Awarded for courage.
Ain't it the truth? Ain't it the truth?
Oh, they're all so wonderful.
Hey, what about Dorothy?
About Dorothy?
Dorothy next.
Oh,
yes, Dorothy.
I don't think there's anything in there for me.
Well, you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. The only way for Dorothy to get back to Kansas is for me to take her myself.
Oh, could you? Will you? Are you clever enough a wizard to manage it?
Oh, my dear, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself. Premier balloonist par excellence of the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company until one day, while performing feats of stratospheric skill, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
Oh, you did?
Frightened, were you?
Frightened? You are looking at a man who has stared in the face of death, sneered at doom, chuckled at catastrophe. I was petrified. And then the wind changed. And then suddenly, the balloon floated down into the heart of this noble city, where I was instantly acclaimed Oz, the First Wizard Deluxe.
Deluxe? From the French, pertaining to luxury.
Yes, well, there were few luxuries that went with the job, but I took it anyway, retaining the balloon against the advent of a quick getaway. And the balloon is ready for the flight. And in that conveyance, my dear Dorothy, you and I will return to the land of E Pluribus Unum. Step this way. Citizens of Oz, I, your wizard, am about to embark upon a hazardous and technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere, what to converse and confer and otherwise hobnob with my fellow wizards. And I hereby decree that until the time I return, if any, the Scarecrow, by virtue of his highly superior brains, shall rule in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man by virtue of his magnificent heart, and the Lion by virtue of his magnificent courage. Obey them as you would me. Thank you, my friends. And now it is time to cast off. Climb aboard, Dorothy, climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy, while the wind is still in your favor.
Oh. Toto, where's Toto? I can't go without him.
Oh, don't worry. I'll find the dog.
No, don't let go of the rope.
Oh, what? The balloon's going up.
Oh, this is highly irregular procedure.
Oh, no, please, Professor, don't go without me.
Too late, my dear.
Professor, you can't go without me.
Come back.
I can't. I don't know how it works.
Oh, Professor, goodbye, folks.
That idiot guard just ruined my exit time.
Oh, now I'll never get home.
Then stay with us, Dorothy.
We don't want you to go.
Oh, I know, but I have to get back to Kansas.
Oh, well, don't you love us, Dorothy?
Oh, you know I do, but there's just a place and people that I love more. Oh, Scarecrow. I thought I was on my way home, and now home seems further away than the furthest dream. And I'll never make it home. Never. I never make it home.
Never is a very, very long time, Dorothy.
Oh, could you please help me? Will you please help me?
You don't need to be helped any longer. You've always had the power to go back to Kansas.
I have?
Why didn't you tell her sooner?
Because she wouldn't have believed me. She needed to find out for herself.
What have you learned, Dorothy?
Well, I think it's not enough just to want to see Uncle Henry and Auntie Em again. I think it's that if I ever go looking for my heart's true desire again, I shouldn't look any further than my own backyard. Because if it's there, I never really lost it to begin with. Is that right?
That's all it is.
Oh, that's so easy. I should have thought of that for you.
Me too, if I'd had the courage of my convictions.
No, she needed to find out for herself. Now those ruby slippers will get you home in 2 seconds.
Oh, and Toto too?
Toto too.
Oh, Oh, I'm going to miss you all so much. Oh. Bye, Tin Man.
Oh. Now I know I have a heart. 'Cause it's breaking.
Oh, please don't cry. You rust so dreadfully. Oh. Goodbye, Lion. I know it isn't right, but I'm gonna miss the way you used to holler for help before you got your courage.
When you leave, I think I'm gonna do a little more hollering.
Oh, here. Oh. Scarecrow, you were my first friend here. I think I'm gonna miss you most of all.
Having a brain don't make parting any easier. Goodbye, Dorothy. I'll think of you always.
Are you ready now?
Oh, please, before I change my mind and want to stay forever.
Then all you do is close your eyes, tap your heels together 3 times, and think to yourself over and over again, there's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home.
One.
There's no place like home.
Two.
There's no place like home.
Goodbye, Dorothy!
I hate to think of her being out all night in the storm.
We better get into town and inform the sheriff.
Yeah, look. Wait.
Huh? Toto!
There she is!
Dorothy! Dorothy!
She's got a lump on her head like an ostrich egg, but the skin ain't broke.
She all right?
Oz? Well, my first name is Chester, but you can call me whatever you want.
Oh, Uncle Henry, you were there too, and...
I'm always here. I'll see that you come to no harm.
You think she's gonna be okay?
For a moment there, we thought she'd left us.
Oh, but I did leave you. That's just the trouble. I've been trying to get back to you for days and days.
Well, it sounds like a bad dream.
Oh, no, no, it wasn't a dream.
Well, sure it wasn't. Remember me? Your old pal Zeke?
Lion.
No, it ain't. And this here's Hickory.
Couldn't forget my face, could you?
Well, no, of course not, but where's the Scarecrow?
Scarecrow? Here's that blanket you asked for. How's she doing?
She'll be fine.
Scarecrow, you lost all your stuffing!
Stuffing?
What'll happen to that field mouse in your stomach?
Well, you gave me more than a field mouse. I had a whole sack of kittens in here.
Dorothy? Dorothy!
Oh, Auntie Em!
Dorothy, you're safe and well.
Oh, Auntie M, you were there too.
Honey, I'm right here.
Oh, well, you see, I was in a real and truly live place, and I know some of it wasn't very nice, but oh, most of it was beautiful. And you were there. And you were there. And you kept rusting up, and you kept pulling on your own tail. And you were a humbug.
Well, we don't have to get personal.
Well, doesn't anybody believe me?
Of course we believe you, Dorothy, but we need to get you into bed.
What about the house? Well, it fell on the Witch of the East, remember?
A storm blew right past it.
And it wasn't a house that fell on Miss Gulch.
It was a telegraph pole.
We won't be hearing from that old biddy until her leg gets out of plaster.
And Toto's safe. And you hear that, Toto? We're home. We're home. Oh, and I'm never gonna leave here ever again because I love you all so, so much. Oh, Auntie Em.